has been collecting ideas, oddities, and jokes of sorts for more than 20 years on notepads, napkins, programs, 3x5 index cards, basically whatever he could get his hands on. Tonight, MJ will share a few excerpts from this 20-year collection. And remember, there's no charge tonight and no minimum for this show. How nice of you. He will be speaking from the advanced manual, humorously speaking. This is actually project number 2. And he is to leave us with a smile. Let's welcome MJ as he presents samples from my joke files.
All right, gonna need a little audience participation to start off here tonight. Woo! Well, he lives in a pineapple under the sea.
SpongeBob SquarePants!
Porous and yellow and sorbent is he.
SpongeBob SquarePants!
Thank you.
Oh, dude,
wanted to see if I can get adults to sing that song. The reason I use SpongeBob is because this is my joke file. SpongeBob is a cartoon. Cartoons are for children to make them laugh on Saturday mornings. That's what my joke file is also. So let's put our children's hat on and try to have a few laughs. In the humorous speaking advanced manual, humorous speaking, Melissa, if you'd hold that up in the air, wave it around one time so everybody can see it. They talk about in chapter 1 that we should collect humorous stories. Always carry a pad with you. When you see something funny happen to a coworker, jot it down. You know, write it on a napkin, write it on a program. If you see something funny happening to an old lady walking across the street, things like that, go ahead and take note of that. And later on, if you hold that, maybe you can turn that into something funny that you can use in one of your speeches later on. My story begins. If I can find the opening. And if everything spills on the ground, we have a contingency. Alrighty. As you can see, I've got notebooks and files and more files and more files. And this is very organized because I spent about 6 hours getting rid of a lot of clutter. There's a rule in comedy, write 10 jokes, throw 9 of them out. So you can imagine there were 3 notebooks, there were some shoeboxes in a closet. I had another shoebox out in the garage and everything, and that all got consolidated this week into just what we see right here. So I'm a little more organized. I also have a couple of books in here. One of the first books I got, How to Be a Working Comic. I'm not trying to be a working comic, but it was nice to have that information. How to Be Funny, a little few more guidelines. And also the Comedy Bible. In the coming weeks, we hope to bring you some humorous education out of some of these books. Start with a joke I've been telling for a long time. 51 years I've had this with me. My birth certificate. It says right here, Michael Joseph Falato, born in Brunswick, Maine. I'm a certified maniac. Hold on to that for me, John. First file here. Can't even open it. Most of the jokes that I've written in the past before I started with Toastmasters got a little few explicitives in there that I might not be able to do right here in front of all of you. We'll go ahead and see what's in this. 1996, 1998 jokes? Are any of them any good? Can I do any of them? Let's just see. I've got all kinds of stuff. You won't see any napkins in here tonight because generally when I write something down on a napkin, I bring it home, I rework it on a 3x5 card. Here's one from way back. What's the difference between Dennis Rodman and Hulk Hogan?
Hair.
Nothing. They're both cartoon characters. A lot of jokes in here. I can't do all these jokes. And again, using the rule of 10 jokes and one will be funny. You don't want to hear those 20. You don't want to hear those 10. 2001, there was a reality show on television. I think Michael Jackson won. He was pronounced the 5th Spice Girl, I believe. Of course, I wrote that when Michael Jackson was alive. Uh-oh, more adult humor. Can't do any of these jokes. Oh, my God. Here we go. The Glenn Gary, Glenn Ross jokes. You got to pay to hear those. Jokes I put on the back of business cards. Can't tell you these jokes either. Maybe one night at Post Toasties we'll do those. A lot of jokes I can't tell you, but these five I know I can. John, would you pick a joke, please?
Do I have to?
Go ahead.
No.
Any joke. Oh, and hand that to me. Oh, boy, this is a good story. When I was at SeaWorld one time, the Japanese tourists, and they're famous, they take a lot of pictures all the time. At the gate, there was this one Japanese tourist that we kind of talked a little bit or nudged each other and whatnot. Later on, for ice cream, we were nudging each other and whatnot. In the afternoon, the Budweiser Clydesdales came, and they're doing a little parade, and everybody's taking pictures of the Clydesdales and everything. And he's got kind of broken English, and he was asking me a few words, and this is and that during the day. Clydesdales were going by, yay, we're taking pictures and everything. And then all of a sudden, the Clydesdales are gone. We all start running after the Clydesdales for some reason. I don't understand why. And it became time for the Clydesdales to relieve themselves. Everywhere. Whoa! I yell, fajitas, fajitas! Oh! He was wondering what he ate last night. All right, can't do much of this.